Welcome to the house of the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Amen. We're going to praise God in His Word this morning. Hallelujah. How many agree with that? Hallelujah. In the Spirit. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. The Bible says, let the Word of Christ dwell in you richly. Hallelujah. All wisdom. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Let the Word dwell in you. If you be risen with Christ, seek those things that are all above. Hallelujah. For Christ sitteth on the right hand of the Father. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I hear scripture like, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. That automatically brings a praise to my lips. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. I can immediately go from the natural into the spiritual. Hallelujah. Bless His name forevermore. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Let everything that has breath give Him praise. Give thanks unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So automatically just move from the natural into the spiritual. Hallelujah. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? Hallelujah. The Lord is the strength of my life. Whom shall I be afraid? Hey, glory, son. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The Lord is my shepherd. Hallelujah. I shall not want. Hey, hallelujah. I just move from the natural into the spiritual realm. Hey, glory, son. God is the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory, the maker of everything. Hallelujah. Those are words of reality. Hallelujah. Glory to God. His mercy endureth forever. Hallelujah. The truth of the Lord. Hallelujah. Endureth forever. Say, Levande, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, that men would praise the Lord for His goodness. Hallelujah. For His wonderful work toward the children of man. Hallelujah. Just automatically move right into praise for Him. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Told all the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. What can I render unto the Lord for all of His benefits toward me? Hallelujah. Just move right into thanksgiving. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hey, Lord, wait sometime. Hallelujah. Bless your name forevermore, from the rising of the sun to it goes down the same. The Lord's name is to be praised. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Then my total being starts to move. My hands raise. Hallelujah. Glory. Lift up your hands in the sanctuary and bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Behold, all ye people of the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Hey, thank you, Lord. Just move right into praise. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. What shall I render unto the Lord for all of His benefits toward me? Hallelujah. My heart rejoice. Hallelujah. Glory, let all those that put their trust in Him. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Lord. Bless your name, Lord. Hallelujah. I cried unto the Lord, and He heard me out of His holy hill. Hallelujah. This poor man cried. Hallelujah. The Lord heard him and delivered him from all of his troubles. So taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the one that will trust in Him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Hey, my Lord, sometime. Glory to God. What would I do? Hallelujah. I will pray with the understanding. Hallelujah. I will sing with the understanding, hallelujah. I will pray with the spirit, hallelujah. Glory, hey, my God, all right, see. This is what we choose to do, hallelujah. Glory to God, I choose to praise him, hallelujah. Glory to God, healing, wonder, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory, as for me and my house, hallelujah. We'll praise the Lord, hallelujah. Let all the people that trust him, hallelujah. Let them shout for joy, hallelujah.
Come on, let's continue on to give him praise right here. Let's continue on to give him praise. We don't have to stop right here. We can continue on giving him praise because he is worthy. He is worthy. He is worthy. He is worthy. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. 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 Give it to him, give it to him. Come on, the devil's been attacking you all week. As a matter of fact, he tried to attack you this week. He tried to attack you on last week, and the week before that, and the week before that. But today we're going to stop him in his tracks on today. This day. You see, one thing I learned about praise and worship is that it's a lifestyle. You don't do it when you want to. It's a lifestyle. It's relationship. It's having that relationship between you and the God that you serve. And one thing I learned about a relationship is that it's a give and take situation. See, in order to receive something from God, you have to give something back, which is your praise, which is your worship. So if we come in here just sitting down on God, we're not positioning ourselves to receive. You have to activate something in the atmosphere, which is your praise and your worship. So how dare we come here and just sit down on God after all that he's done for us? Because again, the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But again, the devil has tried to take your kids, try to take your job, try to attack your finances. But again, on today, we come to stop him in his tracks. So we're going to give him some praise on today. Is that okay? Is that okay? Welcome, Sister Gulita, as she comes.
Glory. So we're going to activate some things this morning. Hallelujah. We're going to command our bodies to get in order. We're going to command our bodies to give him praise. We're going to command our voice to sing this morning. We're gonna command our hands to give him praise this morning. So we're gonna activate some things this morning. I come to receive from God this morning. What did you come to get? Hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together. I command my soul to bless the Lord. I command my the Lord. I commend my soul to bless the Lord. I commend my soul to bless the Lord.
I commend my soul
to bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
So, so, so,
bless the Lord.
So, so, so,
bless the Lord.
So, so, so,
bless the Lord.
Let's go!
I told you all that my mother was suffering with breast cancer. So I went down there this past week for my son's graduation, who's doing really well, by the way. He was awarded Musician of the Year at his school. As a matter of fact, he didn't all the way get the award this year. He got it on last year also. And I didn't know. But going back to what I was saying, I went down there and checking on my mother. And by the way, she's back in church giving God praise. Not on any medication. But again, the devil always has some type of trick up his sleeve. So went down there and got to the house and noticed that my dad wasn't home. So I said, that's kind of strange, because usually when he's gone, we have a family group text that that he has on the phone where he sends us out messages saying, hey, you know, I got to go to rehearsal, because my dad's a musician also. I got to go to rehearsal, you know, I'm going to be there for a few hours. Make sure y'all check on your mother. I said, okay. So normally if you see me with my phone out, it's because of that. So I get there, and again, he wasn't there. Again, like I said, he normally send us out a text if he's leaving. So I get there, my mother was there by herself. So I'm like, okay, my mom and dad. She said, oh, he had to go to the doctor. I said, okay. Thinking he's going for another checkup or something like that. But noticed he was gone for hours. So I said, mom, I said, been kind of, you know, been a few hours that passed, you know, is he going for a checkup? She said, no. She said, no, he had been complaining about his legs and things like that. And so he had been having trouble staying on his feet and things like that because he'd been in pain and been in pain and been in pain. I said, oh, okay, that's something I didn't know. So come find out, he tells me when he got back, nothing ever happened. My dad, he's a macho man, you know. He can't, you know, you really won't know if something is going on with him. So he's like, hey, how you doing when you got here? I said, I'm fine, how are you? So he tells me, I'm fine. I said, that's not what mom just told me. She just ratted you out. She just put all your business out there just now. So I said, what's going on? He said, well, okay, be honest, I have eczema. And they have been unable to cure it. So I said, well, come the devil again. You know, if you can't get one person, he'll try to go to the next. If you can't get that person, he'll try to go to the next person, the next person, the next person, the next person. You know, but again, I'm excited. Because have you ever been in that place where God has to reassure you who he is? And so at that moment on my way back, you know, I began to, of course, pray like, you know, because at the end of the day, my dad is really all my, I have some family down there, but they all have their own lives. And so my daddy has been taking care of my mother like, he's amazing. And so I begin to pray and God tells me, am I not the same God that healed your mother? Your mother is in church. Matter of fact, I get there, she tells me, I go to the car, and I'm moving. I go to the car and get my bags out. She said, where are you going? I said, I'm going to get my bags out to bring inside. She says, well, you want to put on some shoes so I can come and help you? I said, no, I got it. I said, you're going to sit down. But again, you know, God, you know, assured me, am I not the God that healed your mother? You know, am I not the same God that performed miracles, that healed blind man, and still doing miracles today? Today. And then he brought it home for me. He said, am I not the same God that healed Sister Dorothy? I believe that we are still serving a God that's still today doing miracles, signs, and wonders. So I know by the grace of God, he's healed even right now. So that's why I'm so excited on today, because I've learned to praise God through every situation that I go through. Because again, he inhabits the praises of his people.
Continue to show yourself mighty, Lord. yourself strong. Show yourself awesome in the midst of the storm. For in the time of trouble, He will give us a song. So show yourself mighty and show yourself strong. Show yourself mighty and show yourself strong.
Show yourself mighty.
Show yourself strong.
Show yourself strong.
Put your arms in Jesus.
Show yourself awesome.
In the midst of
the storm.
Show yourself awesome in the midst of the storm. For in the time of trouble, He will give us a song. Show yourself mighty, show yourself strong. Show yourself mighty, show yourself strong.
Show yourself mighty,
show yourself strong.
Thank you.
is far more greater than anything. We give you glory.
We give you glory. We give you glory.
We give you glory.
We give you glory, oh God.
We give you glory, Lord.
We give you glory.
Yeah.
We give you glory.
We give him glory.
We give glory. We give you glory,
oh God.
They shall run. from the rising of the sun till the going down of the same. We ought to praise Him, hallelujah. Let's praise Him, 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 let's glorify the Lord, let's glorify the God of Israel. Bible says sacrifice with the sacrifice of thanksgiving. Yeah, 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 yeah. Hallelujah. Sacrifice with the sacrifice of thanksgiving. Yes, declare His works with rejoicing. Declare His works with rejoicing. Give a word of God. Declare His works. Let's declare His works with rejoicing. Heaven shout for joy. Heaven shout for joy. Heaven shout for the joy. Be glad in the Lord and rejoice. For the Lord will do great things. The Lord will do great things. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Everybody that love of Hashanah, that fame of His righteous cause, let them rejoice, let them rejoice, let them rejoice. Oh, hey, I sought the Lord and He heard me, and He delivered me out of all of my distresses. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. There is no one to them that fear Him. Fear the Lord, all ye saints. Fear the Lord, fear the Lord. Fear the Lord, all ye saints. Hey, 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 hey. Hey, let's rejoice in the God of our salvation. Oh, praise Him. Oh, praise Him. Oh, praise Him. Oh, praise Him. Oh, praise Him, hallelujah. Oh, praise Him. Hallelujah. Oh, bless Him. Hallelujah. Breakthrough. Yes, weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Hallelujah, hallelujah, praise Him.
Strength, oh God.
you my strength. Oh, yeah, renew my strength. I'm waiting on you. Renew my strength, Lord. I need more. I need your strength. I need your help, Lord. Can't do nothing without you, Lord. Lord, you're faithful, that promise. You're faithful, hold on my heart. You're faithful, oh yeah, 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 yeah. You're faithful, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. You're faithful, that promise. You're faithful, that promise. You're faithful, that promise, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Faithful is he that calls, faithful is he that will do it, hallelujah. You're the faithful God that keep covenant with them that love you, with them that obey you, with them that walk before you with all of their heart. You're faithful. Oh, just wave your hands and say, you're faithful. Oh, 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 hallelujah. You're the faithful God. You're the faithful God. You're the faithful God. Hallelujah. Who keep covenant with them. Oh, the mighty shed of my heart. Who keep covenant with them, he lot of our own initiative. Who keeps covenant with them, who walk before you with all of your heart. Hey, 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 hey. How many want to walk before him with all of your heart? How many want to, hallelujah, to walk before him with all of your heart, God? Oh, oh. Oh, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, I want more of you. I want more of you. How many want more of you? How many of me? I want more of you. Hallelujah. Just wave your hands and say, I want more. I want more. Oh, yeah, that's my heart. I want more. More of you. Just lift your voice. More of you, hallelujah, oh, yeah, more of you, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. God said he will never suffer his faithfulness to fail. soul. Say yes, do it in me, do it in me, do a new thing in me. Do a new work in me, Lord. Do a new thing in me, Lord.
And put yourself into what your teacher is giving you. You can't pass the test. Well, as you get growner and older, you find out you're still being tested.
That's right.
But you got to find out how you can pass the test. How you can make it through the test. Well, I want to let you know, you can't make it without the Lord. You must have God on your side. And when He's on your side, you got to listen. You got to watch. You have to pay attention to the steps that you take. Not everybody else, but look at what you're doing. Are you being obedient? Where is your love? Who do you love? God loves you. Do you love you? Are you just looking for somebody else to love you? You're not going to know who you are until you know who He is. And why He chose you. Mama and Daddy didn't choose you. Because you know, Mama sometimes say, I want a boy. Sometimes Daddy say, I want a girl. But guess what? The only one that comes out is who God chooses. And when God chose you, He put something special in you because He wants what He has to go forward. But if you're waiting on somebody else to tell you who you are, you're in trouble. If you read His Bible, you'll find out that He tells you, write it down, make it plain. Because when you write it down, you go back and read over it, it becomes plain to you. You know, I used to wonder, Lord, why you wake me up so early in the morning? Well, I found out when I started reading His Word when I wake up. Because He would tell me where to go in the Bible and what to read. I didn't understand it in the beginning, but you know what happened to me? The Lord moved me to Tulsa, Oklahoma. And when I came to Tulsa, Oklahoma, I was going to one church, and someone from Arkansas told me, you need to find where Pastor Hill and Sister Hill are there in Oklahoma. And when I found out where this church was, and I started coming here, I found out why that person thought it was important for me to be here. Because they heard what God told them. And then I paid attention and followed, and I found out why I was here. I needed to get a teacher. You know, when you're in school, if you ain't got a good teacher, you don't learn very well. You want to go to another class. Well, I want you to know, we got two of the best teachers right here. You see, I didn't say one, I said two. Because when you listen to them, you listen and you pay attention, you find out what's going on inside of you. Because if you don't pay attention, Pastor Hill gonna pull it out of you anyway. So you might as well stand up. Because He is led by God. And He's leading you. And you know what, children? It didn't happen when I got to be a teenager or older. It happened to me when I was 8 years old. I just didn't know and understand. But the Lord showed me something that I had no idea of. But I learned from that, that God has placed something in each one of us. And we got to stop sitting back on what God has put in us. And step up and step forward. Because when we step up and step forward, we're going to draw to Him. We're going to draw others to Him. And they're going to be happy and appreciated for what we do.
Well, you can tell she's scared. All right. More to come. More to come. I want to ask, this is a spiritual moment, Sister Christian, just to come here for a second. She's been coming with her kids on Tuesday morning to prayer. And yesterday, on Saturday, they come to Bible study because they can't make the Wednesday night. And she bring the whole family both times. And Brother Walter, so I think that Brother Walter's job
has kind of changed, and we miss him on Tuesday morning. And he kept up a lot of noise. I mean, he brought a lot of energy to this place, but I miss him. Sister Wayne stepped up to the plate. Amen. She's the powerhouse now. Tuesday to Thursday morning. It's just amazing. She's one of the most humble. You know, I think it was Wigglesworth mentioned the book that we are reading, Depression of. He mentioned that he would rather have 100 people in his church that's not spirit-filled, that was hungry, than to have 100 people that were spirit-filled, that were not hungry. Anybody understand what he was saying? Amen. God fills the hungry with what? Good things. Blessed are they that what? Hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. Amen. I believe that her family is going to be the first family, children, filled with the Holy Ghost, because we are believing for them right away to all be filled. Amen. And she is really a humble person, really hungry for God. You have to be hungry to bring your children, get your children out of the bed before school. Is that right? Before school? All right, just say something.
To be honest, I think it was Brother Wayne was up speaking one day, and he was ministering, and he was just kind of admonishing us to come to prayer and come to as many services as possible. And I remember him saying, bring your children. It's not going to hurt them. Just one day out of the week, getting up just a little bit early. And so, I mean, that just kind of struck me in a way that I said, you know what? It's time to do that. And so I have begun to bring them. Last Tuesday I didn't. I let them stay in bed a little longer. But yeah, I get them up on Tuesday. It doesn't bother them. They don't have bad attitudes during the day because they're tired. They just get up and they come right along and they come back here and sleep. And I believe in my heart that even though they're back there laying down, that word is still penetrating in them. I agree with you, Pastor Hill. I think they probably will be the first to get spirit-filled. To be honest, the little one, she'll surprise you. She really will. And I don't know if she's playing or not, but I remember as a kid, that's how it came to me, is playing church. I used to leave here on Sundays, and it used to be me, Amber, and Nicole Brown. And we would leave here, and we would kind of go to somebody's house after church. And we had those little toy keyboards, and they would play like they were in the choir, and we would play as if we were at church at home. And I remember that, and I just kind of feel like that's when I got it at a very young age, is by playing church, not knowing that church was really coming out of me. It was actually pouring into me. So I do believe that my children will probably be one of the first, and if they're not, I'm praying that they get it, and they get it at an early age.
Is that amazing? Amen. Sister Wayne, you might want to just have a word just before we go further. Our goal is that every believer will be filled with the Holy Ghost and experience many refillings. Everybody just said refillings. And everybody just said it's time for a good refilling. And we just want you to, Brother David is going to come, and we are being filled with the word. Amen. Filled with the word. Everybody just say, I got to get filled. And I got to get filled with the what? The Holy Ghost. Filled with the word and the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. So we are going to believe that this coming Saturday, we're going to just release our faith, amen, for that refill. We might have a mourner's bench. Going back to the old school, some of y'all don't speak and don't pray in spirit quite right. Some of y'all just some of y'all just a little stammering. Amen. If you read Acts 2, they spoke in distinct languages, because those that came to Jerusalem for the feast they heard them, they said, all of these Galileans, they heard them speak in a variety of languages. These were clear, distinct languages that they were speaking in. Amen. So we got to go further than zzzzzzz. Amen. So we're going to have maybe a mourner's bench. Maybe we can use this up here, mourner's bench. We're just going to pray for the saints. I'm getting my breakthrough. I got mine next Thursday. Amen. Y'all haven't seen me out on the floor and couldn't get up. Amen. These are not drunk as you suppose. That's what they said in Acts 2, right? Joel said, amen. Peter said, this is what? That was what? Spoken by the prophet Joel. In the last days, God will what? Pour out of his spirit upon what? All flesh. Now we want all of our teachers, you know, it was a prerequisite for all of the deacons and people that were in charge in the early church to be what? Full of the Holy Ghost. Honest, full of wisdom, full of what? Full of the Holy Ghost. Amen. So if we want our children filled, we gotta what? They never hear you praying the Spirit for half an hour. All right, Sister Wayne, come on, see. Come on.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, I just want to share a testimony. Last Sunday we weren't here. We went to Marion, Louisiana, Monroe, Louisiana. And I just thank God for the words, all the different lessons and things, because we prayed and read the word, meditated on the word all the way down 8 or 9 hours, just getting full of his power, his word, and so ready to minister or share with whoever we come in contact. Praying for an overflow. We have to get filled and full so that we have something to give to others. I thank God that they had things planned, picnic and all of that, and had a dance and dinner. And I just praise God that he had said before we left, even though I've been exercising and have all this energy, that we wasn't going to the dance. And everybody's like, y'all not going to the dance? You know, this was the big, no, we're not going to the dance. Well, you went last time, several years ago, we're not going this time. We just, I get my dance on every day. Praising the Lord, hallelujah. Morning, noon, and night will I praise him. So I just thank God for what he did down there. I thank him what Pastor Hill is igniting in us, or refilling, restoring, that word is restoring the joy and the peace, getting full early in the morning when we seek him, his word is just becoming life and his health and his healing to all of my flesh. I had some challenges health-wise and things, but God, every you speak the word, he sent his word and he healed. So I don't have that pain or them others. And I just thank God for what he's doing. And, you know, let me know if you can go started this journey trying to lose weight and lose that stress weight and all of that. And if I can go to the Y and jump around and bounce and do whatever they say do and more, I can come and praise the Lord. I can give him my all. And that's so I'm not doing, if you see me, I'm not doing this for no show, because I believe that we put in the effort to praise him before time. He's taking care of those things that concern us. I came back and my daughter was in the hospital. I just said, the devil is a lie. He can't have her health or nothing else. He can't have anything. So we have to, I think this is, we're doing something beforehand. We're depositing into that bank. You know, so when we need something, it's already there. He's already got it taken care of. So I'm going to rejoice. My song is rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. So, oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. So we in this thing together. So when I'm praising and marching, I'm not just praying for the Waynes, but every one of the brothers and sisters and saints of Christ. in the Lord. So we thank the Lord for the family. I thank the Lord bringing Kim back and the gifts and talents. Like she said earlier, each one of us have gifts and talents. You know, so just give it to God and let it go with it. You know, it's going to bless somebody. It's going to encourage somebody to run on for the Lord. Don't give up. And so I'm just excited, and I plan to stay excited. So I hope y'all, I'm not doing, my praise is to the Lord. My praise is to the Lord. I'm glorifying the Lord. In Jesus' name.
I tell you, she pumps me up. When I hit that door, she'd be circling around the church, and boy, she'd be full of life. Oh, man, I draw from that. Okay, I want to have Brother Trevor just for a second. Just to come other morning, Thursday morning, Brother Trevor starts singing in the spirit. And, you know, Brother Trevor is just kind of low-key, and I'm not trying to make him like me. Amen. But he got pretty disturbed Thursday morning.
Birthday.
And today's his birthday. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And he did something that I hadn't heard him do. Amen. He raised his voice, and man, he's man, that anointing, he couldn't resist it any longer. Amen. But okay. We're going to have a few minutes of bold confessions that's going to prepare us for this coming week. We're going to have handouts too. Brother David is going to help us to read that.
Okay, before Brother Travis comes, you notice where I'm standing. Brother Derek has asked us in the past to stand in the light. And the reason for that, you can see a person better. So for all of the ones that's coming up, would you stand in the light? That's twofold. You can see the person better. And Sister Kimberly is taking pictures for the yearbook, and we want to have quality pictures in the yearbook. And the light reflects a lot better. So if you would, please do so. Amen. Brother Travis, in the light. Stand in the light.
Okay, we just want to say that at the close of the service, we're going to, today's his birthday, and I don't raise birthday offerings for members. I don't do that because everybody would want to have their turn. This brother has been cleaning the church two or three times a week. Every special occasion we have, he cleans it. And he opens the church, he closes the church, he waits patiently until we all leave. And on top of all of that, there are numerous of things that he has done. You know, we would have to be paying him like $500 a month to do what he does, $700. So I'm going to ask for a birthday blessing for him. And later on, at the first of the month, we're going to have one for our assistant pastor, drives the bus, and tremendous children ministry. And so we're just going to just do it for those that we just feel like there's no other way to do it, but to do it this way, we're just going to have to disregard the rule and do a blessing for him. All right, just say a word, Brother Trevor. What do you think about the morning prayer and the evening prayer?
The morning prayer is getting better and better. It's just growing. I really love having the sisters and brothers come out.
Yes.
Get them out of your beds and come out here with us, because it's so much better when there is 15 or 20 of us than it is when there's one or two or three.
We broke the record about 2 weeks ago.
Yes, we had about 25 people in here one Tuesday morning, along with the children. So it's really been a blessing. It's so anointed. It's really been a blessing to me. You know, prayers are getting answered. Just so many things that's happening here. And we just have to continue it. We can't start something like this and stop. So I asked Pastor Hill what he was talking about, more time. So on Thursday mornings, for those who can stay till 7, you know, we'll be here till 7 o'clock on Thursday mornings. Pastor Hill will probably be here longer someone stays. You know, Pastor Hill, he'll stay with him. So please, please, please come out and join us on Tuesday and Thursday mornings. You'll be so blessed. Amen. You'll be so blessed. While I got the mic, I want to congratulate my grandson back there. He knew I was going to do this. Jayton finished the school year with a 3.5 grade average. So he's the main reason why I come. I'm so proud of him. He's been a blessing to me. He corrected me on his grades the other day because I thought he had 4 A's and 3 B's. So that's just wonderful. I'm so, so proud of him. He sits back there quietly, but their brain be working. So I thank you. So please, please, just come out and join us, man. You can't go wrong. It's a benefit for all of us that can't come. We cover all of you. Amen?
Yeah. All right. That's good. Okay, everybody, we'll have the deacons to pass out those handouts. These are the affirmations that we are working on each Tuesday and Thursday. We're going to give everybody a set. And this is, Brother David is going to come. We'll give ourselves 15 minutes on these, but we want everybody to unite in affirming the things that we are believing God to do within us. God is doing a mighty work. We have to keep on affirming the word of God. And that word will become reality as we continue to confess it. You that need your handouts, we have a black notebook that contains all of the handouts. We usually pass this out on Bible study night. If you can't come on Wednesday, Saturday morning at 9 is the time that you need to come to get caught up with all of the teachings, all of the handouts, and all of the things that we are doing in prayer, preparing for our breakthrough. We just want to make sure that you are up to date. If you're not here on Wednesday night, you need to find a way to get in the Saturday Bible study. Now, this set is different from anyone that I have passed out. It's just designed more for Sunday. It's not designed for the studies that shed more light on that material contained. But this is designed more for, it's much shorter, but it does contain all of the admonitions that we want to work on and focus on. So we're going to have Brother David to come and lead us in some of these. We can do Kingdom Power. We can do Mary Heart. Mary Heart. How many want a Mary Heart? How many want a lot of joy? All right, and then we can do Fear Not, Be Bold. Fear Not, Be Bold. Okay, we'll do Kingdom. Kingdom, what did we say? Kingdom Power. Then we'll do Mary Heart. These are the ones that we did Wednesday night, and I think that Bible study surprised me Wednesday night. Boy, it seemed like that fellowship hall was shaken. Amen. Just the word. How many believe the word? All right, there you go. Brother David is going to lead us.
All right. Does everybody have their paper? Say amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Let's first start out with purpose. I like the Lord's Prayer. It says, "Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name." Thy what? Thy kingdom come, thy will be done where? So that's the purpose. That's the purpose for you being here. Establishing his kingdom where? On earth as it is in heaven. So these confessions, right, are going to what? Establish in us a purpose. The purpose of establishing his kingdom on earth as it is in where? In heaven. So we don't have to wait till we get to heaven to have it. We can have it where? Right here on earth. Amen? How about that kingdom power? And we'll read together. Verse 32 says, "Fear not, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom." Let's read that again. It says, "Fear not, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom." Romans 14 and 17. "For the kingdom of God is not meat or drink, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Ghost." So where is righteousness and peace and joy? Where is that at? In the Holy Ghost. Where is the Holy Ghost?
In me.
In me. Praise God. 1 Corinthians 1:24. "But unto them which are called both Jews and Greeks, Christ, the power of God and the wisdom of God." Well, where is Christ?
In me.
In me. 1 Corinthians 1:30. "But of him are ye in Christ Jesus, who of God is made unto us wisdom and righteousness and sanctification and redemption." Let me tell you something. Y'all don't have to fear nothing. First Thessalonians 1 and 5. "For our gospel came not unto you in word only, but also in power and in the Holy Ghost and in much assurance, as ye know what manner of men we were among you for your sake." See, that transitions to you. The manner of man is you. See, you're in the world, but you're not what? Of it. Amen? So God's counting on you, so you ought to be counting on him. The greater one on the inside, amen? Let me move back into the light. 2 Timothy 1:7. "For God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind." Now watch this. God has not given us the spirit of fear. So if fear grips you, it is not of God. But of power. If you feel powerless, it's not of God. And of love. So if you don't feel love, it's not of God. And of a sound mind. And so if you don't feel as if you have a sound mind, it is not of who? God. So you can just scratch that off. Amen? Like the young people say, you know.
Amen.
You can just brush that off. Amen? The Bible says, "Resist the enemy and he'll what? He'll flee from you." Philippians 3:3. "For we are the circumcision, which worship God in the spirit, and rejoice in Christ Jesus, or the Word, and have no confidence in what? In the flesh. Confidence and assurance is in God. Not in your flesh. It's in the Word. Matter of fact, it says the Word brings healing to the what? To the flesh. Amen? Let's go part B. Ooh, I like part A. Kingdom power. Kingdom power will give you a merry heart. Job 23:12. Job. If you ain't got no job, God wants you to have a job. Sorry about that. That was a funny joke. Laughter do a good like medicine. Amen. Job 23:12. Neither have I gone back from the commandment of his lips. I esteem the word of his mouth more than my necessary food. We ought to read that one again. Huh? Even Jesus, after he fasted 40 days and 40 nights, he said, man shall not live off what? Bread alone, but every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. Let's read that again. Job 23:12. Neither have I gone back from the commandment of his lips. I esteem the words of his mouth more than my necessary food.
Praise him.
So you ought to be praying, what are you eating? You ought to be reading the word, what are you stuffing your face? Amen? Psalm 16:11. Thou wilt shew me the path of life, that in thy presence is fullness of joy, and at the right hand there are pleasures forevermore. Praise God. I believe one scripture says, I wish above all things that you prosper and that you be in good health, even as your soul prospers. So as you live this thing, you should expect some resolve, some results. Amen? Hallelujah. Psalms 19:8. The statutes of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The commandment of the Lord is pure, enlightening thine eyes. How many of you all know we ought to spend more time looking at the Word?
Yes.
Not looking at that mess that's out there. Looking at the Word. Reading the Word. Seeing the manifestation of His promise. It says that will enlighten your what? Your eyes. Amen. Amen. Psalms 35:28. And my tongue shall speak of thy righteousness and of thy praise all the day long. So if we spend time speaking the word, we don't have time to speak anything contrary to the word. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's read that again. And my tongue shall speak of thy righteousness and of thy praise all the day long. See, that means if we speaking on righteousness, we speaking about the kingdom. Hallelujah. That'll give you a merry heart. See, no time for gossip and silliness, right? Psalms 51:12-13. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit. Then will I teach transgressors thy ways, and sinners shall be converted unto thee. Ooh, that's good. That's good. Yeah, let's do that again. If you want to expand the kingdom, this is a good one. Praise God. Psalm 51:12-13 says, restore unto me the joy of thy salvation,
and uphold me with thy free spirit. Then will I teach transgressors thy ways, and sinners shall be converted unto thee. Oh, man. I think the scripture says, the joy of the word, or the joy of the Lord is my what? Strength. See. And if you keep that before your eyes and keep that on your tongue, see, you'll be forever full of joy. And then your ministry will expand. It said, and then I will teach transgressors thy ways, and sinners shall be converted unto thee. Hallelujah. Psalm 63, 5 and 6. My soul shall be satisfied with marrow and fatness, and my mouth shall praise thee with joyful lips. When I remember thee upon my bed, and meditate on thee in the night watches. Woo! That just affirmed what we just talked about, didn't it? Hallelujah. Psalms 119, 50. Then we skip to 92. Then we skip to 97. It says, this is my comfort and my affliction, for thy word has quickened me. Unless thy law had been my delight, I should then have perished in my affliction. Oh, how love thy law. It is my meditation all the day. Hallelujah. 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 Man, these are good. You know, these are all in Psalms. And so David was speaking these things. How many of you all know David was blessed? Psalms 119 and 165. That's a large book. Praise God. It says, great peace have they which love the law, and nothing shall offend them. The scripture also says, the law that what? Killeth. But the spirit behind the law will give it forth life. Praise God. Great priest.
Hallelujah.
Let's read that again. Psalms 119, 165. Great peace have they which love thy law, and nothing shall offend them. It's important that we follow this order of confession. Because we can take the law and we can kill people. It says, but thy tongue shall speak to the righteousness and of thy praise all the day long. See, you keep going down those scriptures, and then it says, great peace have they which love the law, and nothing shall offend them. Proverbs 12 and 25. Heaviness in the heart of man maketh it stoop, but a good word maketh it glad. How many of you all know when you start off a little wobbly? Huh? It's always good when you get a good word. Especially from somebody who know who they are in the Lord and can speak with authority. Huh? Hallelujah. That's you. Hallelujah. Proverbs 15 and 13. A merry heart maketh a cheerful countenance, but by sorrow of the heart the spirit is broken. Now, you ought to be able to tell what a person is by that countenance, the scripture says. Huh? So when you see a person, you know what you're dealing with. So you ought to pray that God give you a word from on high in season. And that person gets a merry heart. And that sorrow becomes a cheerful confidence. Amen. Yes. Hallelujah.
Proverbs 15 and 23. A man have joy by the answer of his mouth, and a word spoken in due season. How good is it? I like that, because how good is it is a question. But he put an exclamation point on it. See, that ought to tell you that's good. That, as grandma say, that's gooder. Proverbs 17 and 22. A merry heart doeth good like a medicine, but a broken spirit drive the bone. Ecclesiastes 2 and 26. For God giveth to a man that is good in his sight wisdom and knowledge and joy. But to the sinner he giveth travail to gather and to heap up, that he may give to him that is good before God. This also is vanity and vexation of spirit. Grandpa used to say, you better get your get right together. When your heart isn't right, it's a vexation to the spirit. And it's just a quick change. Just a change of the heart. Amen? Praise God. Jeremiah 15 and 16. Thy words were found, and I did eat them, and thy word was unto me the joy and rejoicing of my heart. For I am called by thy name, O Lord God of hosts. Whew. Boy, it is good when the Lord knows your name. Ephesians 5:18-20. And be not drunk with wine, wherein is access, but be filled with the Spirit, speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord, giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
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 How many of you all know that you're the exclamation point to his sentence? Huh? You are the exclamation point to his sentence. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. D, you gonna cut off there, Pastor? Praise God. Praise God. God will redeem the time. Hallelujah. This is good. You guys ready to shout these out? I won't go into any other scriptures. I stay with the paper, all right? Is that good? All right, it says, fear not, be bold. That means you got to shout these out, all right? So Psalm 66 and 8. Oh, bless our God, ye people, and make the voice of his praise to be heard. Psalm 74 and 21. Oh, let not the oppressed return to shame. Let the poor and the needy praise thy name. Job 2 and 21 says, fear not, O land, be glad and rejoice, for the Lord will do what? Great things. Hallelujah. Yeah, y'all missed a great place to shout. I like that. Hallelujah. Isaiah 41 and 10. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Ooh. Ooh, that's good. Luke 1:74-75. That he will grant unto us, that we being delivered out of the land of the enemies might serve him without fear. in holiness and righteousness before him all the days of our lives. Luke 12:32 says, fear not, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Romans 5:17, for if by one man's offense death reigned by one, much more they which receive abundance of grace and of the gift of righteousness shall reign in life by one, Jesus Christ. Romans 8:31-32. What shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he? Corinthians 3:5-6. Not that we are sufficient of ourselves to think anything as of ourselves, but our sufficiency is in who? Who also hath made us able ministers. What type of ministers? Able ministers of the New Testament. Not of the letter, but of the Spirit. For the letter what? But the Spirit giveth forth what? Life. Hallelujah. What type of ministers? Able ministers. And then watch this. He established the fact that not only are you able ministers, but you able ministers under the new dispensation.
Yeah.
The greater promises. Hallelujah. 2 Corinthians 10:4-6. For the weapons of our warfare are not what? But they're mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations, and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ, and having in all readiness to revenge all disobedience when your obedience is fulfilled. Y'all ought to say that every time you wake up. If you don't think you have the power over sin, you ought to say that confession every time you wake up. Every time you think of sin, you ought to say that confession. Hallelujah. Philippians 1:28. And in nothing by your adversaries, which is to them an evident token of perdition, but to you of salvation and that of God. Hebrews 10:38. Now the just shall what? But if any man draw back, my soul shall have no pleasure in him. When you ready to draw back, remember, that ain't a God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hebrews 10:38. Let's say it again. Now the just shall live by what? But if any man draw back, my soul shall not pleasure in him. But what are we going to do? We're going to do James 4:7, right? Submit yourselves therefore to God. Resist the devil and he will flee from you. 1 Peter 5:8-9. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking who he may devour, or who he may draw back. Whom resist steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same afflictions are accomplished and your brethren that are in the world. Revelations, and this is the last one, so you ought to shout this victory. Revelations 21:8. But the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and whoremongers and scorners and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. You know what I love about that confession right there? Is that they don't have to wait for hell to get there. If you don't pay attention to this stuff in this lifetime, it cannot come nigh you. Get that. God forgave us a sin that we don't have to partake in it. What I mean by that is, not only do you not have to live in sin, but you don't have to allow somebody else's sin to intrude upon your life. Get that. I'm going to repeat that. God forgave sin, shed his blood for the remission of sin, not only that you don't have to live in sin, but that you don't have to allow other sin to intrude upon your life. An offense is something that has to be taken.
Yes, yes.
Are y'all following that? Offense is something that has to be what? Taken. If you don't receive it, it cannot come nigh you. How many of you all got something out of these confessions? All right. Take them home and confess them every day. Amen. All right. We just word up with the word. Amen. After we read this, we just put everything down and just let it gush out. Let the power of God work through us. Hallelujah. All right. We just thank God for the word of God. Now, you better wake up, admonitions. You better read that too. Sister Deborah's expression, you better wake up. I heard two nights ago, that they were saying that we better get ready to die because the president might push his hand on the red button any time. These are news people saying that. So you better wake up. You better read. You better wake up. And then we have others, weapons of mass destruction. Sister Deborah's teaching and Brother Michael's and Sister Denise, what's love got to do with it? You better read those. You better work. You better read those. What's love got to do with it? All right. Let's all, amen. Let's all stand. We're going to let you go and thank God for Brother David reading these admonitions. And just keep feeding on these until you just get full of the Word and full of the Holy Ghost. And it'll be a real blessing to you. Father, we thank you for all of those that are giving in, being a blessing to one that has been a great blessing to this ministry. Lord, we thank you for his work, his ministry, his commitment, his faith, and his love, and his tenacity. Lord, we give you praise and glory for all of the things that has been deposited in us, and much has been due to the sacrifices that he has made. And we give you praise and glory. We thank you, Lord. We count this a privilege and a rare opportunity to sow into his life. And we give you praise and glory now. In Jesus' name, everybody say amen.
Amen.